I didn't know if this was recording. All this time I was talking about 140 plus garlic down there. In there, you can't really see it on this type of viewfinder because, you know, design flaws. It's a Sony, so here you go. Anyway, but right there is what I was talking about. There's like a, it was a hump, now it's gone down because of all the mud. It's all muddy out here. This is the third day without rain, but it's gonna rain tonight. So it's gonna, we're gonna have to wait until probably the end of March to till this thing. The back, we pulled out that plastic back there about 2 weeks ago and letting it sit, and we were gonna till it up. But like I say, then it rained for like 3.5 days straight, and everything's flooded around here. The river's still up to the bottom of the tracks that train is going over on. But anyway, I was saying the voles are so bad I can walk on the grass here and my feet are sinking where there are trenches below it, because it's just voles everywhere out here. So it'll probably be about another about 2 weeks at least before we can start, we can till up back there. I've got three bags of 15, 15, 15 fertilizer. So I'm gonna put like a half a bag on this one, half a bag on number two, and then use 3/4 of a bag on the west half of number three, and then the end of the bag and a half bag on number three on the east end over there, till it in. But we got a lot of tomatoes. We got around 30 tomatoes and peppers growing right now in the house. I'll do a short video on that just to show. This will be okra. This goes sold right into the ground here. It'll be okra seeds go out here. And then maybe peppers also. I'm not sure what else we're going to put with it. But yeah, we can have 3 rows right here of okra. And that'd be more than enough for 3 people, 4 people. We've been putting so much out here, to more than what we need. But freeze a lot of it. We got stuff in there from 2 years ago almost. It's no good now. It's got freezer burn. But then over here will be beans and peas. Gonna have basil on the ends over there, 4 of them, and then I might do a few around the back on the north end over there, and then tomatoes and then some peppers and then cucumbers, and then we're gonna have watermelon and cantaloupe over here, plus I don't know what else yet, but that's the basic garden how it'll be this year. Might put more peppers back there. Might put peppers and Mexican okra here, so I have to look and see what. Look, I even got sunflowers down there growing. I can see, I don't know if it'll come in out here. The big green petals. Again, I can't see on the viewfinder. Those are sunflowers that are growing here. So that'll be pulled up, of course, unfortunately. We'll have sunflowers. I'm gonna till the outer ring. I call it my sunflower fence. Oh, on the east end here. Hold on. It goes, starts here. Let me just back up. Stuck on a mound here. See, it starts right here, which is almost even with the front of this. Goes all the way back to the edge. Goes across about 60 feet or so past the burn barrel back there. You can barely see that one plant. It's a sunflower from last year. It's left in the side, in the ground. So I have a place where I'm going to till and then come up the west end over there. On the other side of CJ and Lucy's grave, and over there until it, so it'll be a giant U with torch and yellow sunflowers all through here. So that's the premise right now. That's the basics. That's how I want to go. But how it goes, we'll see when it starts happening.